Hi guys, welcome back. We are now on episode 41 of our Bury Save. Now, last episode wasn't great. We only picked up 3 draws. That being said, guys, I am really, really enjoying this save. It has been a really good challenge. So I hope you guys out there are enjoying it as well. And if you are, you know, comment, subscribe, like, and yeah. So you can keep up to date with all of our ridiculousness that we keep getting into. Let's just get straight into this Bristol City game. Just get straight into it. It's a hungry we are for a win is just getting straight into the game. We're getting a few in. I'd like one of them to go in. That would be good. We've never beaten Bristol City. We've only played them twice. They have put 6 goals past us, though, which is the ref penalty. Oh, my God. That's... Yeah, excellent. Good. Good. It's annoying we missed the penalty. What do we get the penalty for? He was fouled in the penalty area going past the goalkeeper and he didn't get sent off. That's a joke. That's a joke and a half. Check out these conditions. -1 and hail. Ugh. Gans making up for that missed penalty. That's what I'm talking about. And then Kuki Salazar gets an injury. Cool. Alright, let's bring Brady on. Hopefully he can do something. He's been really far out. Been really poor this season. He needs to. I mean, he wants to leave, so I don't want him to leave. Any changes? Everyone seems to be playing really well, apart from Jozo Simunovic. We might go for another 10 minutes before we make a decision. This is not cool. Not cool. Let's bring emotion and Tom Beery on. We're gonna do this. We're going for it. Let's hope that this does something, because we're gonna chuck this one away. We should have had the goalkeeper sent off. Gans! It's got to be the winning goal. Take you off that. No. Okay. Team instructions, defensive, long, normal technique. No. Men behind the ball. Smodix back to there. Yes! Oh, that's a good, solid win. That is a great win. Trebelli, man of the match with an assist and a goal. 2 for Simone Gans. Could have had a hat-trick if he'd nailed that penalty. That's good. Back up the 13th. Nice. 10 days. Excellent. George Osborne. Good work rate, good technique, good set pieces, flair. I'm gonna add him to the shortlist because he could be good. He might be good. All right, Brighton, that's gonna be a tough one. They are top of the table, and they are cruising. When do we play them? It's October. Let's push on. Excellent. That was a good win. Good. I'm glad we got that win in. Because I was. 5 games without a win is not good. Tom White. Right back. 16. He's not too... You know, he's not too bad. I wonder how he compares up against Woodell. How do you two compare? Well, he's obviously a lot better, isn't he? No, you know what? We're going to go past. I think... I think we've got better options at right back. Although our two other right backs are a little bit old, but let's just check that his Jamie Forbes. Gavin O'Driscoll, he's gone to Antwerp. Dean Fletcher, yeah, we're getting Dean Fletcher. This guy looks fairly decent. Cool. Been through that. Looking good. That was a good win. Like I was saying before, we just dove straight into that game. I was just so keen. I just wanted to get out there and get it done. Like I said, guys. Episode 41. We're just getting through these. I'm really, really enjoying this save. I hope you guys are too, because yeah, it's one of the better saves I've done. It's a lot of ups and downs, and that's what you want. That's what you want. You want a little bit of. Hold on, I'm just gonna pause it for a sec. Sorry, guys, we're back. Quick pause there. There was a bug emergency. He's not. Too, am I getting tricked by this guy? No. I've fallen for that trap before with Will Nightingale. I can't remember what I was saying. Really enjoying it. A lot of ups and downs. It's good, you know. Look. Steven Gerrard's Brighton manager. That's what you want. Timo Pukki. Yeah, you want him too. And John Garrett, 20. He's pretty good. Anyway, let's go. Brighton. We've never played them because they just got relegated. Kuki Zalzar's the only one who's going to miss out. How did Brady do when he came on? He's got 7. His morale's back to okay. We're going to put him back in at left and put Trebelli, who is just an absolute gun. I mean, oh my god. I made him sign a new contract without a minimum fee either, because holy shit. He has balls. His stats are great. Low on the bench. Gans were good. I'm going to put McConnell on. Macaulay Bond, he's slipping it down the ladder. Let's go. Brighton. At home. At the mighty fortress that is Gig Lane. I feel like we're getting the ball forward. Had a shot already that they keep out to defend. And we're getting forward again. Simone Gans. Oh, him and Trebelli have just been, they've just been combining really, really nicely lately, and we are dominating Brighton. Absolutely dominating. They got nothing on us. Absolutely nothing. That's really good. That's a really, really solid first half. Batu has a foot injury. That's not good. We will make a change. We have got some good defensive midfielders, but we still will make that change because I don't like losing anyone for long periods of time. Like the goalkeeper I bought, who's still injured. And yeah, that's another story altogether. He is actually as well. I am off camera. Sorry, lost my train of thought. David Ivan playing crap once again. Ivan stay on and let's bring McConnell on for Gans. We need him to keep his game time up, otherwise he's gonna get annoyed. Boom, McConnell. Inspired substitution there. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, and we dominated Brighton there. Absolutely dominated. Wow, he must have had a storming game. Got an 8. Good headers. 1. Tackles. Good. David Ivan got the assist in the end. That was another solid win, guys. Another solid win. Good. 2 on the bounce. And we are back up 2 points off of Borough. Excellent. Yes, as I was saying, the other goalkeeper I bought, who, I mean, you may have forgotten about him, because he's here. He's back. He's back to full-time fitness. Played a couple of games for the reserves, playing well. This is the problem. I took another physio report on him. He needs to undergo surgery again. Ollie Krappinen is playing really, really well. I do have Boyce Clark, who, I mean, he was pants in his debut, but he's decent. He's technically, I think he's actually better than Ollie. He's actually better than him. Yeah, look, he's 3 stars better than him. And I've got him for the whole year, so... I still have Madison as well. I need to get him fit, but I'm worried that if I don't get him fit, he's just going to get injured here and there and everywhere, and it's going to be a pain in the butt. So I'm going to send him for rehabilitation 6 months again. He just cannot catch a break. Poor guy. Poor boy, that was a loud mouse click. Super loud. Yeah, poor guy. He just cannot catch a break at this point in time. I feel so bad for him. I have been desperately trying to sign this guy, but he will not come to a semi-professional club. So hopefully he leaves on a free and I can grab him, and hopefully... What did Brady get last game? Another 6. Just come on, mate. I'll pop him down in the reserves. We're going to get a... create a note in 1 week. Confirm. Yeah. Alright. Enough mucking around. We've got Millwall. It's a long time before we've got Millwall. It's 2 weeks. It's 2 weeks before we've got Millwall. I'm going to pause and I will meet you at the Millwall game. See you then. Alright, guys. We are back. It was a long 2 week gap. We had some internationals. Some people did stuff. It was good. Friend Gamez is back. He is... I'd like to say he goes straight back into the first team, but he's... been a bit crap. Shock horror. So he is going to stay. He's going to go to the bench. He's coming back from an injury anyway. Kuki Zalzar is back, which is good, as we're still keeping Brady down in the reserves because, yeah. I'm going to bring Jobson back into the fold. I know David Ivan's been playing well, but hopefully a couple of games on the bench has made him, change his tune or something. Ivan will go back to the bench. Other than that, it's the regulars. Millwall. We have a pretty good record over Millwall. Let's continue it. Penalty denied. Excellent. They have, like, out of the blocks firing Kuki Zalzar. Yes! We're really hitting a little bit of form, which is excellent. Millwall coming back a bit, but we're getting a lot more shots. Smodix! Oh yeah. That's good. Good. Little tweaks there. Some little tweaks of tactics seem to have paid off. Smodix again with another goal. Oh, what a great first half. We are dominating Millwall up to 8th. Excellent. And we are just goal difference out of there. Brilliant. Let's get back on. I didn't check anyone's condition. Everyone looks pretty good. Good. Bodvarsson. John Daddy Bodvarsson. God, he's got a record and a half. He's been banging the goals in. Anyway. Kuki Zalzar with another one. Yeah, everyone looks good. Watu's got a yellow. Mouchon for him, McConnell and for Gans. Trebelli's having a quiet game, but we won't make that final substitution just yet. And then look at that magical stuff. Oh, Smodics with a hat trick. Let's get him off. Let's take him off. He's done his job. He's probably got an injury. Nobody's on 80%. Let's take him off for... Of course, it took Tom Beery off. Let's take him off for David Ivan. That's cool. We'll roll with that. Oh, we have pumped Millwall. Absolutely. Oh, McConnell makes it 7. Holy shit balls. Oh, had a penalty. Could have been 8 then. Jeez. Oh, thank God. That would have been a bit of a blemish. Wow. Their goalie must have had a... Like, realistically, you say 50% of the shots, but 7-1. 7-1. Oh, that's an amazing... I think that is almost our biggest win. Is that our results? Biggest win? Yeah, 7-1. Wow. Wow. As Owen Wilson would say. Wow. 3 games on the trot. We are gunning for Stoke in 3 days' time. Wow, I'm flabbergasted. I don't think we've ever played this well. This is brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. So happy. Yep. So happy. I'm enjoying this save. Gans didn't get a goal, which is frustrating. Yeah. Not sure what to do with the striker situation at this point, because I don't know who to play. I mean, Macaulay Bond's 26. Simon Gans 29. McConnell's 22, but... this might... Yeah, I mean, none of them's going to get top score in the league if I keep kind of rotating them through. But... Yeah. I don't know, Macaulay Bond, he might have just slipped down that pecking order a bit. Which is... It's almost unbelievable. You might get a game here because I have some tired people. Jordan Clark. Jobson. It's good to see him come back in and play well. Simone Gans is at 100%. And Macaulay Bond back onto the bench. Other than that, looking good. Stoke. We have never beaten Stoke. We have not even scored a goal against Stoke. Not even scored a goal against Stoke. So hopefully we can change that. Smodics, he is on fire. Gans in as well. Smodics again. Oh my God, Creed. That was a great first half. Really, really great. We're hitting a little... How is Jack Butland still a Stoke? He usually goes. Anyway, we're playing well, despite Oliver Creed getting sent off. Everyone's all good fitness-wise. He's got foot injury, obviously. Give him a little bit longer. Yep, we'll take him off now. Jordan Clark. Macaulay Bond. Yep, we'll leave it at that. And just keep an eye on Smodics as well, because he can drop quite dramatically. There's another really solid win. We've shut Stoke out here. Obviously, as I... I have got to keep my big mouth shut. Every time I say that, they score. Oh yeah, Semismotics again. We're back up where we should be, a point behind Wednesday as well. 1 point behind Wednesday. They played an extra game as well. Ooh, tasty. Tasty. What did he do? What did he do? Creed was pronounced holding. Stuart was... I'm going to peel that. I think 3 matches is a bit stiff. Alright, we've got Sunderland then on Sunday. Now, Sunderland are having a pretty ordinary season. They have had a bit of a plummet down to the bottom. Key Dons and Colchester, oof, they're not having a good season. Did we play Colchester already? We did. We drew 1-1 with them, obviously. That was the disaster of the last game. Anyway, let's go. Let's push on for the Sunderland game. Sunderland, we've played them a few times, and they generally speaking, have the wood on us. The woody. McQuiddington. Yeah, they... Rob Brady. Yeah, they've generally given us a touch up. Rob Brady, how are you looking? You get your morale's low. Your morale's low. I'm at this point prepared to let you go for a bit. Let's say you're not needed. What happens then? Bump it back up to a mil. Okay. All right. Ooh. There's a problem as well with being semi-professional. Our player values are just not that high. Like, with the patch I've got on, the values are at 2x amount. So, for instance, Brighton, pick someone in, Davy Proper, 5.5. Whereas, my best fielder, 600 thou. No, you're not having him. Nope. Sunderland on Sunday. This is turning into a perfect episode. It's getting there, and we are scoring goals, which is good. Good. Ooh. Yeah, you can go. He's gonna go. Robbie Brady's gonna go to Shabab Dubai in the UAE. Wow. Can they afford a million? We'll see. The reserves too. Awful. Aaron Lennon. Jeez. The Aaron Lennon. I say the Aaron Lennon. He is old though. Wait, I just want to have a look back at that game. 14 flair. Bravery 13. I was checking that because he's obviously his regen might come out soon. Dismiss the man. Brady's going. He's going to Shabab Dubai. It's a shame, really, because, I mean, in his 2 and a bit seasons here, this season's been a bit of a, but his 2 full seasons here, 26 goals, 23 assists, really good average rating there. He's been a really good servant. I got him for free, and to sell him for $1 million is pretty good. We get his massive wages off the bill, which, I mean, we are losing money, but we've got heaps in the bank, and his contract runs out at the end of the year, so he's gone. Just like that, he is gone. Robbie Brady has gone to the UAE. Bit disappointing that it went a bit downhill towards the end there, but bummer. There's not a lot we can do about that. Oh well. There's not a lot we can do about that. And he's gone. We got $1 million for him. Like I said, his contract was going to expire in June, whatever, June next year. So, I mean, in what, like two and a bit months, he would have been able to leave for a free. He's 30 years old, so cash in on him. Wesley Fongak. Fongak. It's an interesting name. He's a bit old. Jamie Rooney. No, he's crap. Completed youth search. Yeah, I was quite impressed with this Joe Feeney guy, but then he's going to Bristol Rovers. I think we've pretty much checked everyone here. just have another quick skiz through here. Yep, got another goalkeeper. Couple of DMCs here. Got a lot of Irish kids, which is weird. Another goalkeeper. Ben Simpson. I'm tempted by this guy, Carl Stewart. It's this. Sells me on this every time. So, I don't know, we'll see. Another goalkeeper. You know what? Search, you can back out. Find those gems. Oh, nope. Alright, here we are. Gammers was excellent. Just down the bench. Page. Yep. Jobson can go back in. Other than that, everyone's looking pretty good. Did Macaulay Bongi got a 6? Alright. Sunderland. As I said, we've beaten them once. They really do have had the better of us in our games that we've met. Hopefully we can put that down. We've been, like, this will be the last game of the episode, and we win this, and it has been a perfect episode. And it has been a long, long time since we've had a perfect episode, and I probably literally pissed on my chips by saying too early that we're going to have a perfect episode. But we're dominating them, which is good. Haven't managed to get the ball across the line though, which is disappointing. Salt. Yeah, I'm not even going to bother with that. Tasty free kick there. Should have had a penalty. We look like we're giving them. Let's make an impact sub. Do these. Injury again. Alright, actually let's cancel this. Yeah, I should have checked conditions before. So Pietro Trebelli, he will be definitely coming off. I do not risk an injury for him, as will Smodex. And friend Gammers. Unfortunately, all injury substitutions. I don't want to. Ooh, Gans. Let's close it down. Defensive, long, normal. Don't behind the ball. Yes. Oh yeah. Holy crappin and man of the match. It was pretty even actually. Once again, he's playing really bloody well. He kind of has like an off and a good and an off and a good season. So he's playing really well. And Matt is jumped us up to third. We can't look at it that way. What a meteoric rise that has been this game. We were down in 18th. And We won 2, 3, 4, 5 straight wins. Wow. And in those 5 games, we've conceded 4 goals and banged in, what's that, 5, 12, 16 goals. Wow, guys. That is absolutely amazing. None of our guys are showing up anywhere, but whatever. Who cares? It's an excellent episode. So happy with that. We might have finally turned a corner with this team. Thank you, guys. I hope you're enjoying it. I am loving it. Like, subscribe, comment, and I will catch you next time. Bye.